Okay, Dr. P. Srinivasulu garu, Dr. Uttam Kumar, and Dr. Sudhir, Principal Gems, Dr. Lakshmi Lalita, APAFMT President Dr. Fanindra garu, Secretary Dr. Srinivas garu, and Vice President Dr. Sanjeev Rao garu, and Dr. GVS Rao garu, and my beloved students. Warm good afternoon to all of you. God be delayed because I had one meeting which extended, and because of that I have to be late here. And first of all, thanks Dr. Sanjeev Rao garu for those kind words about me, and I'm very happy to be here for AP Forensic Medicine Conference 2019. And the theme, I was thinking something will be related to forensic medicine, and you were thinking, and after coming here and seeing the theme, yeah, it's very relevant. With the recent light of incidents that have happened, medical negligence and violence against doctors, so it requires a bit of deep thought into the things that have happened and what's happening. I mean, whether something is going wrong somewhere, and where are all the loopholes? So it requires analysis from all the fronts, not only from the medical fraternity, from the administration side, from the public. Everywhere we require an analysis of where we are going. I mean, what is it that we are into, right? Before that, I mean, being in this conference of forensic medicine, I'm very happy that to note that there is an association for forensic medicine, and they are organizing this conference. And many of you, I'm seeing that though it's a very scientific subject, forensic medicine has been given, over the years has been given, I would say, the kind of the least importance in terms of from the government administration side, or even from the medical fraternity side, even from the colleges also. I was just inquiring whether there is an MD forensic medicine. I'm told that no, there is no course, because it requires proper permissions and permissions for postmortem and facilities for postmortem and all those stuff. Because of that, it's not there. I mean, why is forensic medicine so important, I mean, these days? Because since I have served as in the police department for almost 9 months, where forensic medicine is also a subject for us, there we got to learn about the beauty of the science, and then the kind of strength which a forensic evidence can bring into a case. In one way, if a, you know, by unfortunate event, a person dies, maybe murder or any other, you know, gruesome incident, you see the beauty of nature. Even if anybody, I mean everybody in the world has left this fellow, and nobody is going to say an evidence on his part or in his favor, due to various reasons. Maybe there may be a fear factor, there may be other factors, hostile witnesses, no interest. The nature is made in such a way that the final remains of a body, of a person, it itself is going to speak the truth. And by law, you all must be aware that the truths given by the forensic medicine and forensic evidence cannot be disputable, and the convictions based on forensic evidence has been the most conclusive conviction that has been ever happened, and there has been no any second thought or second, opinion of a judgment that has been purely based on a forensic evidence. That has been the great, the success of forensic medicine, or I would say the great place which the forensic medicine and science enjoys in the present system. You know, lot of cases, there have been many hostile witnesses, circumstantial evidences fail, documentary evidences fail, but then at last, if you see, if any case of conviction that has happened, that is mainly due to the forensic evidence that is the convictions are happening. If you see the records in the civil court, in the criminal courts, in the court that has been happening, you will be able to understand the fact. But then what's happening? Lack of awareness and lack of facilities. The state, we have very, very limited, forensic labs. We have a lab in Vijayawada. And you know, the time that is taking for the forensic evidence that is coming, testing, because they loaded so much of cases. And then there is also, even from the police side also, and the people involved in the forensic medicine, proper training is also has to be there in the terms of preservation of viscera, the specimens, how to preserve them, how to transport them properly, how to take the samples properly, and then getting the results out of the forensic labs. You know what? There are cases where even the results are pending for almost about 1 year, where in the developed countries this would be happening, say, in a period of, say, 1 week or 2 weeks, and then the conviction happens very fast. But though we have good facilities, we have very limited facilities in the state, you know, in terms of forensic medicines. I hope you'll acknowledge. So there is every need for establishing a district-wide forensic lab in every district, you know, and it's not going to cost much, but the kind of turnaround it is, which it's going to create in terms of the cases getting solved, it's going to be phenomenal, if you see. And then the interest forensic medicine, you know, that is going to create among the medical fraternity, it is also going to be phenomenal. If you see in foreign countries, even, you know, they are way ahead in terms of the forensic medicine and then the importance they give for forensic medicine. You know, the crime scene preservation, which is a very, very, very important task, unfortunately, we have been giving the most least importance to the crime scene preservation. Recently, you would have seen the incident of a murder that has happened in the district of Kadapa. The politician, prominent politician, Vivekananda Reddy's murder. You can see how the crime scene was not, there have been allegations that the crime scene was not properly handled. There have been suspensions of the inspector who was involved in the case, that the evidence was not properly collected, were not properly preserved. And had there been a proper evidence, and till today the case is not solved, it's getting, it's getting pending. Why? Because we didn't, there have been problem that has been acknowledged, because it has been in the record that an inspector was suspended in that case, involving the case, and that is, I'm going on record. Why? Proper training has not been given to the staff, not only for the police department also, but then, you know, their aspect has always been towards the law enforcement, and the crime is a different angle. So there is every need for them to also to be trained properly in forensic medicine. You know, the many cases, even involving SCS autopsy cases also, when I'm sitting in the district vigilance and committee monitoring meeting, it will be very painful to see the number of convictions that is happening in those cases. Very painful. The conviction rates are not even 10% that is happening in those cases. The reason being is that not proper evidences, whether it may be forensic, whether it is documentary or hostile witnesses, that is being there. So I hope with more you know, emphasis into the forensic medicine. You know, it's not only a medical oriented you know, issue, but if you are going to focus on this issue, it is going to resolve lot many cases, and then it is going to give justice to the most deserving people and the most voiceless people and against the powerful people. So I hope forensic medicine has got such a potential, and with this conference, you know, a lot of people should take more interest into forensic medicine. And annex to the forensic medicine is again the medico-legal case. What's happening in medico-legal case? Again, there is a lack of awareness, both from the medical side, from the hospital side, and also from the administration side, from the public side also. In any case, even there is the smallest of an accident, a fellow is lying down, you know, and then there is a fear that once a medico-legal case is registered, and then hospitals, you know, they say that, you know, the police has to complete the formalities, and then only they have to be, the treatment has to start, they have to inform the parents, and are the relatives. If you remember, there have been a recent judgment from the Supreme Court. A judgment has to be issued for only the specific purpose that in case of any medico-legal case, irrespective of the circumstances of whatever it has happened, the treatment has to start, and a special directive was given to